Welcome all. Today we will look into ladder friction. Actually, it is a part of friction. There are different types of friction. Today we will look into the ladder friction. Ladder friction means here we can see a ladder is leaning against a wall. And that ladder makes an angle of alpha degree with horizontal direction. Alpha degree with horizontal direction. And whenever this ladder is leaning against a wall like this, then there must be some self weight which is acting at the center of gravity of the ladder. Then due to that weight which creates a turning effect, and when this angle alpha is decreasing at a particular level, at a particular position, this ladder is have a tendency to move downwards. This particular end is moving downwards, and the end where the ladder touching the floor is moving leftwards. This is the case, and here this ladder is touching floor at point A, and this ladder is touching the wall at point B. We can treat this point as point B, and then if a particular body is touching another body, then there must be a normal reaction, and this ladder is acted upon by a normal reaction from this wall, and we can name it as RW, which is perpendicular to the surface of the wall, and the same ladder is acted upon by an external force or by a normal reaction RF, which is perpendicular to the surface of the floor. Then there must be a frictional resistance to prevent the motion of the ladder, and at the floor it is parallel to the floor surface, or at the floor that particular friction is horizontal because the floor is also horizontal, and at the wall the frictional resistance is vertical. That means that floor is wall is vertical, so that friction force also in vertical direction. And here is one note: the normal reaction at the floor will act perpendicular to the floor. Similarly, normal reaction at the wall RW will also act perpendicular to the wall. And this is the problem. Here, a ladder 5 meter long rests on a horizontal ground, and leans against a smooth vertical wall. Smooth vertical wall means whenever that particular surface is smooth, then the coefficient of friction mu must be equal to zero. Here the this vertical surface is smooth. That means mu w, the coefficient of friction at wall, is equal to zero. Then automatically that frictional resistance also become zero. That means frictional resistance at wall fw must be equal to mu w rw. Whenever this wall is smooth, then mu w is equal to zero. Then automatically fw must be equal to zero. That means there is no friction force at contact point B. Then at A there must be some frictional resistance to prevent the motion of the ladder, and here the a smooth vertical wall at an angle 70 degree with the horizontal. That means this angle between this ladder and horizontal direction is equal to 70 degree given. That means this angle is equal to 20 degree. Then the weight of the ladder 900 newton acting at its middle. That means the self weight is acting at the center of gravity, and the ladder is at a point of sliding when a man weighing 750 newton stands on a rung 1.5 meter from the bottom of the ladder. When a man climbing upon the ladder, and at this particular position, which is at 1.5 meter away from the end A along the ladder, the ladder is at a point of sliding. Then we can calculate the coefficient of friction between the ladder and the floor. We have to calculate this mu f. Then given the length of the ladder 5 meter, angle which the ladder makes with the horizontal alpha is equal to 70 degree, weight of the ladder is also given 900 newton, then weight of the man 750 newton. Okay, then here let mu f is equal to coefficient of friction between ladder and floor, and rf is the normal reaction at the floor. Rf is the normal reaction at the floor, and mu f is equal to coefficient of friction between ladder and the floor. Then resolving the forces in the vertical direction, we have rf vertically upward. Rf is equal to total forces in the vertically downward forces. Total vertically downward forces is equal to 900 plus 750 newton. Then Rf is equal to 1650 newton, which is equation number 1. Then force of friction at A, force of friction, this Ff is equal to mu f into Rf. Mu f into Rf. Rf we have already calculated. Then mu f, we have to calculate this value mu f. Then Ff is equal to mu f into 1650. We can treat that equation as equation number 2. Then now taking moments about B, we can take moment about B. Then moment due to all the forces which is acting at B must be equal to 0, because the moment of a force means force into perpendicular distance between the moment center and the force. Then when we taking moment about B, then moment due to all the forces acting at point B must be equal to 0, because there is no perpendicular distance between line of action of forces and the moment center. That is the condition. Then if we take moment about B, we must calculate the moment due to 750 newton, moment due to 900 newton, then moment due to Rf, then moment due to Ff. Here, while closely examining this particular figure, we can see that moment due to 900 newton is equal to this 900 into perpendicular distance. This distance is the perpendicular distance between line of action of 900 newton and moment center B. This distance that will create an anti-clockwise moment. That will create an anti-clockwise moment. Similarly, moment due to 750 newton, that also creating an anti-clockwise moment. Then moment due to Rf, Rf into perpendicular distance, Rf into perpendicular distance between line of action of Rf and this point B is equal to this one, this distance. Then Rf into that distance will create a clockwise moment. Clockwise moment. Then moment due to Ff, that's equal to moment due to Ff means Ff into perpendicular distance. The line of action of Ff is like this. Then the perpendicular distance between that line of action and that line of action and B is equal to this one. This is the perpendicular distance. Then moment due to Ff at B is equal to Ff into this perpendicular distance. This perpendicular distance that will create an anti-clockwise moment. An anti-clockwise moment. So that the total clockwise moment must be equal to total anti-clockwise moment for equilibrium. That means moment due to Rf, moment due to Rf is in clockwise direction. Then moment due to Rf must be equal to sum of all other moments due to other forces. Three forces will create a moment in anti-clockwise direction. In anti-clockwise direction, so that the clockwise moment must be equal to sum of anti-clockwise moments. Then Rf into perpendicular distance means this distance. Here we can have a right angle triangle like this. Right angle triangle ABC, ABC like this. Then we can take that AC, that base length, as AB cos 70. AC is equal to AB cos 70, or otherwise AB sin 20. Sin 20. This we can treat this angle as 20 degree. Then AB sin 20. AB is equal to 5 meter. AB is equal to 5 meter. Then Rf into 5 sin 20. Rf into 5 sin 20 is the moment due to RF. That must be equal to FF into this distance. This distance is equal to 5 cos 20 degree. Then FF into 5 cos 20 degree. That will be in anti-clockwise direction, positive. Plus then 900 into 2.5. 900 acting at the middle of the ladder. Then 900 into this distance. This distance is equal to this 2.5 sin 20. 2.5 sin 20. Then 750 into the remaining distance. Remaining distance is equal to total distance AB is equal to 5 meter. Then A to this particular point, the distance between this the line of action which will meet the ladder. Line of action 750 Newton, which will meet at the ladder, is equal to 1.5 meter. Then the remaining distance will become 3.5 meter. Then 3.5 sin 20 is the perpendicular distance between the line of action of 750 and moment center. This distance. Then we can substitute F of S mu F RF. That's equal to mu F into 1650. Then we can create this particular equation. Then and now substituting the values of RF and FF from equation 1 and 2, we can substitute RF and FF from these two equation 1 and 2. Then we can have this particular equation, equation number A. Then dividing both sides by 5 sin 20, we can eliminate this term from left hand side. Then we can eliminate 5 sin 20 from right hand side also. Then the first term will become mu f 1650 is equal to mu f into 1650 cot 20 plus 975. Then we can solve this equation and we can easily find out mu f. That mu f is equal to 0.15. That mu f is equal to 0.15. Then there is another question. Two identical blocks weight W are supported by a rod inclined 45 degree with horizontal as shown in figure. If both blocks are in limiting equilibrium, find the coefficient of friction mu, assuming it to be the same at floor and wall. Here mu f is equal to mu, then mu w, coefficient of friction at wall, also equal to mu. Then we can find out, we have to find out that mu. For this we can given the weight of the block A and B is equal to w, then we can draw the all the forces which is acting at A and B. Here frictional resistance towards right, then RF vertically upward, weight vertically downward, then RW which is perpendicular to wall, then W of the block B, weight of the block B, W vertically downward, then FW vertically upward. Then mu is equal to coefficient of friction, then resolving the entire force system in vertical direction, then we have FW plus RF is equal to 2W. FW plus RF is equal to 2W. RW vertically upward, FW vertically upward, then 2 times W vertically downward. Then FW is equal to mu into RW. We can say that FW, frictional resistance at wall, is equal to mu into weight, mu into RW is the normal reaction at the wall, mu into RW. Then plus RF is equal to 2W. Then we can resolve these forces in horizontal direction. Then RW is equal to FF plus RW is equal to FF. There is only two forces in the horizontal direction. Then we can substitute FF as mu into RF. Then we can substitute this RW is equal to mu into RF, equation number 2, in equation number 1. then we can have this particular equation mu into rf plus rf is equal to 2w, then mu square rf plus rf is equal to 2w, then rf we can take rf out of the rf from both the terms, then rf into mu square plus 1 is equal to 2w, then rf is equal to 2w divided by mu square plus 1. And substituting this value in equation number 2, we can substitute this value in equation number 2. Then rw is equal to mu into rf. Then rw is equal to mu into rf is equal to 2w divided by mu square plus 1. Then we can take moment about A. Then all the forces acting at point A will disappear, because the moment due to all the forces acting at A, moment due to that forces must be equal to 0. Then we can consider only three forces. Then rw into perpendicular distance, this one. Rw into perpendicular distance, rw into L cos 45 degree. We can treat this length as L, and this angle is equal to, if this angle is equal to 45 degree, then this angle also equal to 45 degree, then this angle also equal to 45 degree, then this length is equal to L cos 45 degree. Then FW into perpendicular distance, this one. FW, line of action of FW is this one. Then FW into this one also L cos 45 degree. That's equal to two forces will create an anti-clockwise moment. RW creates an anti-clockwise moment. Then FW also creates an anti-clockwise moment. Then moment due to W is in clockwise direction. That's equal to W into L cos 45 degree. Then we can eliminate L cos 45 degree from all the terms. Then Rw plus Fw is equal to mu. Then Rw plus mu into Rw is equal to W. Then Rw into 1 plus mu is equal to W. Then we can substitute this equation. Rw is equal to Rw into 1 plus mu is equal to W in this equation number 4. Then we will get mu into 2w divided by mu square plus 1 into 1 plus mu is equal to w. Then we can cross multiply. Then 2mu into 1 plus mu. Or we can take 2w. We can rearrange this particular equation, and we can create an equation like this. We can create an equation like this that will be a quadratic equation. Then by solving this equation for mu, we can calculate that mu as 0.414. Here moment due to Rw is in anti-clockwise direction. Moment due to Fw is in anti-clockwise direction. That means that two forces we can take at one side. And moment due to W is in clockwise direction. Moment due to W at A, that must be in clockwise direction. That will take at the other side of this particular equation. Then finally, we can calculate mu as 0.414. Thank you. Thank you all.